So hi guys, I'm Swapnil and welcome to yet another video tutorial of PrepBytes. And in this video, I would be discussing the problem Chef and Meetings of the February Long Challenge 2021 Division 3. So let's get started with the problem statement. The problem statement goes like, Chef has scheduled a meeting with his friends at a time P. We would be noting down the important points while reading the problem statement. So here, the chef has scheduled a meeting with his friends at time P. He has N friends, okay, and they are numbered from 1 to N, okay, and for each valid I, the ith friend is available from a time Li to a time Ri, both inclusive, okay. So we are given that our chef has set a time to meet with all his friends at P. And he has got N friends and their availability is given by two bounds, which is Li and Ri. Okay. And for each friend, we will have to find out if this friend will be able to join the meeting or not. More formally, we will have to check if Li is less than equals to P is less than equals to Ri for each and every valid I. Okay. So the input goes like, the first line of the input contains a single integer t, which is the test case, denoting the number of test cases. The first line of each test case contains a single time p, which is the time set by the chef for the meeting. And the second line contains a single integer n, which is the number of friends of the chef. Now the n lines follows. And there are two space separated times, Li and Ri. Okay, and these are the respective availability of the friends of my chef. Okay, the output here would be, for each test case, print a single line containing one string with length n. And for each valid I, the ith character of this string should be 1 if the ith friend will be able to attend the meeting, or 0 otherwise. Okay. And moving to the constraints, we have T ranging from 1 to 500, N ranging from 1 to 500, and each time is valid in 12-hour clock format. This is something you should note down, that all the times given over here is in 12-hour clock format. And for each I, the time Ri is greater than or equals to Li. Okay. So basically, Li is my lower bound and Ri is my upper bound of availability of the ith friend. Moving to the sample input and output, this is the sample input and this is the output. We would be discussing the sample input output in the coding section. So let's move to the coding section. Okay. So here, as I said earlier, meeting is set at a time P given in 12-hour format. And he has got N friends with availabilities in the form of L to R. L is the lower bound and R is my upper bound in same format. Our task is to check if Li is less than equals to P is less than equals to Ri, and output 1 if yes, otherwise 0. So this is the basic gist of the problem. So now we would be discussing the sample test cases. So the time for meeting is 12:01 a.m. Okay. Now we are given that chef has 4 friends. The first friend is available from 12 a.m. to 11:42 p.m. So yeah, this guy would be able to attend the meeting. So for this guy, my output would be 1. For this guy, he is available from 12:01 a.m. to 11:59 a.m. Okay. So for this guy also, he would be able to join the meeting. Now, the third guy, he is available from 12:30 a.m. till 12 p.m. Okay, so 12:30 a.m. is greater than 12:01 a.m. right? So he won't be able to attend the meeting. So for this guy, the answer would be 0. And for the fourth guy, he is available from 11:59 a.m. okay, mark over here. After 11:59 a.m. 12 p.m. comes. Okay, and after 11:59 p.m. 12 a.m. comes. So 12:01 a.m. is not in between these two bounds. So for this also, my answer would be 0. So this is the first sample test case. Moving to the second one, the time which is set for the meeting is 4:12 p.m. Okay, so now there are 5 friends of the chef. So for the first friend, the time of availability is 12 a.m. till 11:59 p.m. Okay, so this guy would be available for the meeting because 4:12 p.m. lies between these two time ranges. And the second guy is available from 1 p.m. to 4:12 p.m. So yeah, because the bounds are inclusive, this guy would also be able to attend the meeting. For the third guy, he is available exactly from 4:12 p.m. till 4:12 p.m. So because the time is inclusive, as given in the problem statement, the bounds should also be inclusive, because over here we have to check less than equals to. So this condition is also true. Now this condition, 4:12 a.m. to 4:12 a.m. this is not true, right? Because 4:12 p.m. is what the time of meeting is. So this is false. And for the fifth guy, he is available from 12 p.m. till 11:59 p.m. Okay, so this means 12 p.m. in the noon till 11:59 p.m. in the night time. So yeah, this time comes in between because this time is in the evening. So there would be one output for this particular guy. He would be able to attend the meeting. So what is the funda in solving this particular question? How would we approaching to solve this particular question? So here what I would be doing is, I will be converting each and every time to total number of minutes. Okay, so initially my meeting is set at 12:01 a.m. okay, so 12:00 a.m. is my starting line, which means at 12:00 a.m. there is 0 minutes. At 12:01 a.m. we are having 1 minute. And at 12 p.m. I am having 12 hours into, in each hour we have 60 minutes, right? So we would be having total 12 into 60 is equals to 720 minutes, right? So we would be converting each and every times into total number of minutes. And accordingly, if we have converted each and every time in number of minutes, then we can easily compare it, because all the variables which are getting compared is converted into minutes, right? Okay, so here let me show you with the test case. Here total number of minutes over here is 1 minute, right? For this one, the L is having, let me write in brackets, total number of minutes for this one and total number of minutes for this one. So this is having 0 minutes, and 11:42 p.m. would be having 11 hours into 60 plus 42 minutes, right? And added to this, because it is p.m., so 12 hours is already done over here, because while a.m. I am calculating from 12, right? So from 0. And in case of p.m., I will have to add 12 into 60 because my count is from 12 a.m. right? So in case of 12 p.m. I will have to do this thing, right? Okay, so in this particular case it would be 11 into 60 plus 42 plus 12 into 60, because this is 12 in the night time, in the midnight time, and this is 11:42 p.m. means this is also in the night time before midnight, and this is just at midnight. So this is my time over here. So after calculating, what we would be getting is 11 into 60 is 660, and 11 into 60 plus 42 plus 12 into 60, which is 720. So here the total number of minutes would be 1422 minutes. Okay. And here you can see that 1 minute is my meeting time. So yeah, I can say that 0 less than equals to 1 less than equals to this thing means 0 less than equals to 1, which is the meeting time, less than equals to 1422. So this is this for this particular query, this guy can join the meeting. So 1 is my answer over here. You can see that. So this way you can see for other times as well that we would be getting such scenario. Okay. Fair enough. Let's write the pseudo code for how to solve this particular question. And I'm writing pseudo code because by writing the pseudo code, you would be able to convert the pseudo code to your favorable language, which can be Java, C++, C or Python or any other language you want to write in. Okay. So first of all, here I have my input as meeting time. Let us say the meeting time is given in string S. Okay. There is a string S. That is my meeting time. Okay. So I will have to get total number of minutes of meeting. So I am making a variable S mins, which is giving me the total number of minutes in S. Okay. Okay. Now for each and every query, let us say it is total n friends are there. So I would be writing while n minus minus. Basically, I am moving to each and every friend, or we can say that loop for each friend, I am taking input as string L and R as input. And in by taking the input, what I am making it, I have another integer L means, which is converting these particular strings L and R into total minutes. R means is converting into minute. Okay. And now for each and every friend, we would be checking if S mins is greater than equals to L mins and S mins is less than equals to R mins. If this condition is true, then we would be printing 1. Otherwise, we would be printing 0 without any end lines because we want our answer in this particular format. And finally, after each and every friends are done, we would be printing endl or end line. Okay. So this is the basic pseudocode. Now what this convert function is doing, let us write the pseudocode for this convert function. So convert is doing nothing but it is taking S, which is the string. Okay. And here you can see that the times are given in two strings. One is showing the time and one is showing the meridian, AM or PM. So why not make this particular thing simple? Let us say I am taking one more string SM and I am sending SM also in my convert function. And here string LM and RM. LM and RM are nothing but the meridian for the string L, and RM is the meridian for string R, SM is the meridian for string S. And I am also sending LM and RM in the convert function just to simplify the process. So convert function is taking the strings, two strings. Basically, the first string is showing the hour and minute format and the second string is showing the meridian, right? So here total number of minutes would be nothing but, let us say, mins is equals to, first of all, we would be taking S of 0 into 10. S of 0 minus 0, obviously, because we have to convert s of 0 to integer and we are multiplying it with 10 plus s of 1 minus 0, because we will have to convert this particular s1 into integer, and this whole thing is getting multiplied by 60. Why am I doing so? Because s0 and s1 is representing my hour. 12 is my hour, right? Here 12 is the hour. So I would be multiplying this with 60. Plus, for the minutes case, I needn't multiply with 60, right? So I will just make s3. S2 is this particular semicolon. We need not worry about the semicolon. S3 minus 0 into 10 plus S4 minus 0. Right? S4 minus 0. Okay. So this would be my expression for getting the total number of minutes in each and every case. And I would be just returning this particular thing. And but wait a minute, what is the work of this SM over here? This SM is nothing but this is showing that what the meridian is, as because my starting line is AM. So if my SM of 0 is equals to P, basically if it is not AM but then it is PM, then I would be adding mins plus is equals to 12 into 60, right? And 12 into 60 is nothing but 720. So I would be adding 720 explicitly over here in cases of PM, basically in the late afternoon time. Okay. And we will have to take care of the cases like 12 AM, because I want to count this 12 AM as 0000 AM. In my 24-hour clock format. But in 12-hour clock format, it is 12 a.m. But in 24 hours, it is 00. So for these cases, I will have to make another if condition, that if my S0 is equals 1 and S1 is equals 2, then make S0 equals to S1 equals to 0, just to make 0 minutes as the starting line for 12 a.m. And for 12 p.m. I'm making again this as 0, because in that case, if it is 12 p.m. then this expression would be giving me 0, because s0 and s1 is 0 and s3 and s4 are 0 in case of 12 p.m. as well, because in even if it is p.m. my S0 and S1 is 1 and 2. So S0 and S1 has been converted to 00. But then here is the condition that if SM of 0 is P, basically if it is prime meridian, then I am adding 720 minutes. So for 12 PM, it would be returning 720 minutes. So this is the basic pseudocode for solving this particular problem. I hope you have got the pretty basic idea how to solve that. Let me move to the C++ code for your better understanding. Let me remove this hash define long, it is not required. Okay, so as I said, I would be taking string. First of all, we are having in t, which is the total number of test cases, I am taking input c in t, and while t minus minus, I am running this solve function. And in this solve function, I am taking s and st as input. Basically, the string which is showing me the time, and it is the meridian one. Sval is nothing but it is converting my time SST to total number of minutes. And for each and every query Q, or let us say total number of friends N, I'm having LLT RRT and I'm taking it as input. So my Lval will be giving me total number of minutes in the lower bound, and rval would be giving me the total number of minutes in the upper bound. If lval is less than equals to sval and rval is greater than equals to sval, as shown over here, this expression only, I am printing 1 over here, else I am printing 0 over here, and finally printing endl. And the convert function is, as I said, that if s of 0 is equals equals 1, if it is 1 2 in the hour clock, then I would be making it as 0. And this expression is the same expression which I showed you during writing the pseudocode. And if it is the prime meridian, then I am adding 720 explicitly. Let us run this particular code. Okay. And let's see what is the output. So you can see that it passed successfully all the sample test cases. Let me copy this one after commenting the free open lines, and let us try to submit this one over the CodeChef platform. Okay. Let us go to submit and let us paste our code over here. Okay, so this is our code. Let us submit this one. Submit. Okay. I hope you got the pretty basic idea of how to solve this particular chef and meetings problem. Okay, so we got an AC over this solution. Thanks for watching this video and keep coding.